You're watching the International Daily Roundup with People's Dispatch, where we bring some of the major news developments from across the world. Today's headlines: 76th session of UN General Assembly to focus on climate crisis and vaccine inequity. 5 social leaders assassinated in Colombia in latest round of violence. Report accuses Taliban of steadily dismantling human rights in Afghanistan. Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau elected to serve third term in snap election. The 76th session of the UN General Assembly was convened on September 20th. Over 100 heads of state and world leaders will attend the meeting held in the US. Key issues on the agenda include the climate crisis and the extreme inequalities in vaccine access. The UK hosted the informal Climate Leaders Roundtable on Climate Action on Monday. The meeting followed a UN report which said that under the current climate pledges, global emissions would increase by 16% in 2030. It also noted that countries like India, Saudi Arabia and China had not set tougher standards. At the current level of emissions, global temperatures could rise to 2.7 degrees Celsius. The matter will be discussed at the UN Climate Conference in Scotland next month. The UN has also asked rich countries to abide by their commitments under the Paris Agreement. This includes a pledge to provide $100 billion each year to help vulnerable countries respond to the crisis. However, Oxfam has said that there might be a shortfall of $75 billion in funds during the 6-year target period. The organization has warned that hot and cold temperatures could kill 5 million people each year. The climate crisis could also trigger economic losses equal to double that of the COVID-19 pandemic. 5 social leaders and indigenous people were assassinated in Colombia on September 20th. Maria Nancy Ramirez Pulgarin was a teacher and a member of the Association of Institutes in Antioquia. The Ombudsman's Office had previously issued 35 alerts regarding armed violence in the area. 2 members of the indigenous Awa community were also killed in Nariño. Dilio Belarin from the Imbera Iabido community was killed in Choco. David Aracapa Visk from the Nasa community was assassinated in Coca. According to rights group Indepaz, 124 social leaders and activists have been killed in Colombia in 2021. An estimated 74 indigenous people have been murdered. Colombia is among the most dangerous countries for rights and environmental defenders in the world. The UN High Commissioner for Human Rights has documented reports of 143 murders between January and August. The agency has alerted of the possibility of systematic murders of social leaders. According to Global Witness, 65 environmental defenders were killed in the country in 2020. The violent attacks have also targeted former combatants of the now demobilized FARC group. Since the peace accords were signed in 2016, 286 ex-members have been killed. Rights groups have accused the Taliban of steadily dismantling human rights in Afghanistan. A new report has documented targeted killings of civilians, the blockade of Panjshir Valley, and limits on the press. The document was released by the International Federation of Human Rights, the World Organization Against Torture, and Amnesty. It also points to the restrictions imposed on women's right to education and work. The group has eliminated the Minister of Women's Affairs. It has been replaced with the Ministry for Preaching and Guidance and the Propagation of Virtue and the Prevention of Vice. Footage on social media showed women protesting outside the ministry on September 19. The report also notes the crackdown on dissent. The Taliban has stated that all protests, including signs and chants, must be approved by the Ministry of Justice. Meanwhile, there have been several reports of door-to-door searches for activists. An NGO worker cited in the report stated that 2 of his colleagues had been beaten. The Taliban have reportedly also taken over the offices of Afghanistan's Independent Human Rights Commission. Canada's Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has been re-elected to serve a third term. Nearly 98% of the votes have been counted in the country's snap elections held on September 20th. As per initial results, the ruling Liberal Party has won or is leading in 158 constituencies. This has fallen short of the 170 seats required to form the majority in the 338-member House of Commons. Meanwhile, the Conservative Party is set to secure 119 seats. The Social Democratic, New Democratic Party has gained 25 seats and the Green Party has only secured 2. Observers have argued that the snap election was an attempt by the Trudeau government to maintain the status quo. The government was heavily criticized for the delayed evacuation of Canadian and Afghan civilians from Afghanistan. The rollout of COVID-19 vaccines also began only in April. This was months after Canada reportedly hoarded enough doses to vaccinate each citizen 5 times. The government has also been criticized for its lack of action on the issues raised by indigenous communities. And this is all we have for this episode of the International Daily Roundup. For more such stories and videos, visit our website peoplesdispatch.org, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Thank you for watching.